Hi friends, a hearty welcome to this road safety training session. Let's see the screen. Let me share it with you so we can start ahead. So this road safety training session comes to you from R Nisarga Foundation under its brand name SMILES, which is Safety for Miles. Senapati Tata Tope Foundation is in association with R Nisarga Foundation doing these road safety training sessions for various schools last couple of years. My name is Rajashree Tope and I am from Senapati Tata Tope Foundation. Last 10 years, we are conducting road safety training sessions with various multinational companies, for corporates, schools, colleges. So, what are the workshop objectives? Road safety per se is a very vast topic, but today we will look at only about three main aspects of it. Helmet, rather to ensure effective use of helmet for the rider as well as pillion, to ensure effective use of seat belt for everyone in the car, not just the driver and the co-passenger, but also the rear seat passengers, and also to ensure no mobile phone usage on the road. So what do we achieve from that? Getting closer to our real goal, which is achieving zero crashes, zero injuries, right? So let's move ahead. Oh yes, we definitely want zero crashes. We definitely want zero injuries. But what is today's statistic? Statistics tells us it's unfortunately a very grievous situation. India has a dubious distinction to be world's capital in deaths due to road crashes and collisions. What number are we talking about? Over 150,000 dying on the road every year. And these are only recorded numbers. Number one position across the world, right? India shares about, you know, maybe 2% vehicle population vis-a-vis the world's vehicular population. But if we compare the fatal crashes where you know, the life is gone there on the road. Over 11% of road fatalities are from India alone. And that's why we are really treading a very dangerous path as we walk on the road, as we are riding our bikes or as pillion riders and passengers and drivers inside the vehicle. And we must take precautions. United Nations goes on the record saying, stop calling them accidents. These are not accidents. What is an accident? Something which is beyond my control, beyond the control of a human being. Like earthquake is an accident. It's a natural calamity. Cloudburst is an accident. Tsunami is an accident. It happens. But on the road, I cause my vehicle to hit the other vehicle. Not intentionally, but maybe I'm distracted. Maybe I'm at high speeds. Maybe I'm talking to the co-passenger. Maybe my eyes are not on the task as I'm riding. Maybe I'm listening to music. I'm distracted. Reasons could be N. But it does not happen. The crash is caused by either something which is I'm not doing right, or I fail to understand the unsafe behavior of the other road users and he comes and hits me. It's one in the same. I get injured, right? So all crashes and collisions, if we take care of it, can be avoided. And we talk about what are the safety precautions when it comes to helmet, seatbelt, and phone. Let's move ahead. First rule as a pedestrian, always walk on the footpaths. So often we see there's a footpath there on the road And even then, pedestrians are not walking on the footpath. When the footpath is not there to the side of the road. But let's understand, I walk on the footpath, but which side of the footpath do I walk? I mean, footpath's there on the right side of the road and also on the left side of the road. And if I'm traveling in a direction, what side of the road should I be walking? Okay, let's look at it this way, that if I'm in a vehicle, what side of the road my vehicle moves? For example, when you children travel from home to school or back home with your parents, what side of the road are you traveling? Look, in India, vehicles always fly, always move on the left side of the road. Now, as a pedestrian, if I'm walking on the left side of the road, I don't see those vehicles coming because they're coming from behind. But there is some driver who is probably, you know, going at high speeds, doesn't see me or loses control. Some rider is riding the bike like this, or his eyes, you know, somewhere reading a hoarding, comes and hits me. I'm not even aware because he's behind. But if I walk on the right side of the footpath, which means I cross the road, now I'm on the right side of the footpath, like in this picture, the second picture here, I see the vehicles coming from opposite direction. So if I see someone is doing something unsafe, I can quickly run away and get out of the situation. Yes or not, right? So which side of the footpath should we be always walking on the road? Always walk on the right side of the footpath. Let's move on. Not on the edge of the footpath. Not like, look at the second picture. So many pedestrians walking on the road. And these two kids, side of the footpath, that too playing. What if she pushes the little fellow and it's that time some two-wheelers coming at a high speed? So always walk on the footpath, right side of the footpath. And like, for example, this lady and the boy who's traveling, who's walking as pedestrians, they are on the left side of the footpath. If they want to travel in this direction, they should cross the road, go on the right side of the footpath, so they see the oncoming traffic. Another picture. Not just kids, but even adults. Now look at the taxi coming from behind, the scooter coming from behind, the tempo coming from behind. I would say it wasn't my fault. He was driving at a high speed, or he was talking on the phone, or he was distracted. But it's my life, and I must take care of my life, irrespective of others' unsafe behavior, right? So always walk on the footpath and on the right side of the road. And wherever a footpath is not there, always at the side of the road. Crossing. Zebra crossing, wherever there is a zebra crossing, please ensure that you are using that zebra crossing to cross the road, because vehicles moving on the road are aware that that's the crossing there. Maybe a pedestrian is crossing. And you children, when you are crossing the road, you're small. You know, you're not that tall. Become tall, become big. How do you become big? Raise your hand. The moment you raise your hand, you become big. Raise your hand, and what are you trying to tell the other vehicles? I want to cross the road. A lot of times, the driver does not see that little fellow, the little child, that boy or a girl, and that's why that vehicle comes and hits the child. So you become big so that they see you, and then you cross the road. Always use zebra crossing. Wait for the vehicles to stop. So which means you wait for your green signal. And you should see clearly in both the directions. Not just, that's not enough. Driver should also see you. So ensure that driver there waiting at the signal sees you that you're crossing, right? But in India, a lot of times there are no zebra crossings. And even on zebra crossing, when you're crossing, what is the strategy that you must use? Stop. Whenever you want to cross the road, don't run. What do you do first? You stop. Then what do? You look. Where do you look? You look to your right, because that's where traffic is coming from. You look to your left. Maybe from wrong side traffic is coming. Or you look at the traffic coming from the other side, right? So look to your right, look to your left, keep looking. As you're looking right and left, listen. What are you listening for? There are lanes and by lanes where you don't see them. You don't see the vehicles coming. But if somebody's coming at a high speed, you hear that noise, the engine. You know, this is not the safe situation for me to cross the road, right? So what have you done? You stop, you look to the right, look to the left, keep listening. Think, is this the right time for me to cross? And then cross the road. So what's the strategy? Stop, look, listen, think. Try doing this actually as an exercise as you're watching the video. What will you do? Say it 4 times. Stop, look, listen, think. When you want to cross the road, stop, look, listen, think, and then cross the road. Stop, look, listen, think, and then cross the road. Stop, look, listen, think, and then cross the road. So now if you do it faster, see what happens, okay? And I want you to do this as you watch me doing it, right? So we go faster 4 times, okay? On your mark, get set, go. Stop, look, listen, think. Stop, look, listen, think. Stop, look, listen, think. Stop, look, listen, think. Yeah? How? So what do you do now? I'm sure you're laughing. Why did I do this? When you do these exercises, when you're actually on the road, it'll remind you, oh, this is what I want to do. When I cross the road, I stop. I look, listen, think, and then cross the road. So promise, always while you're crossing on the road, stop, look, listen, think, and only then you cross the road. Thank you. Let's move on.
1, 2, 3, 4. When you want to cross the road, look to your right, look to your left, look to your right. You want to cross the road, look to your right, look to your left, and look to your right. Hey, there's more to that. Boy, it's more.
Let's move ahead. Never run when you're crossing, no matter how much hurry you are in. Whatever is the issue, stop, look, listen, think, and walk when you're crossing the road. Never run. Okay, so the learning, I will always cross at the zebra crossing and never run across the road. 2 types of signals. There is a manual, there's a police, there's a cop there, and traffic lights. Also in traffic lights, the red, green, and amber is for vehicles, and the red and green is for the pedestrian. So if I'm a pedestrian, who's a pedestrian? Anyone who walks on the road is a pedestrian. So if I see a green signal, which will be there's a man walking on the road, which means I'm allowed to go. If I see the red signal, even if there is hardly any vehicles, do not cross the road because you have a red signal there for the pedestrian, right? And for vehicles, red means stop, green means go, and amber means slow down. You're about to get a red signal now. Slow down and stop. A lot of time you see these over bridges and skywalks. Where would you see them? Where the traffic is, pretty thick. Why are these over bridges and skywalks made? For whom are they made? For the pedestrians. Have you ever seen a car jumping up onto the overbridge, hitting someone and coming down? No. They are on the road, but look at the second picture. How many pedestrians are there? Not on the footpath, they're actually on the road, right? So wherever you know there is an overbridge or a skywalk, please make use of it. You are far safer there, right? And not on the road. Another precaution. Do not hide between the vehicles. It's not about just you watching the traffic, but the driver should see you. So don't hide and run while crossing the road. Never play on the road. Now, look at this, for example, this white car, okay? These two girls are probably playing hide and seek. Some driver is in a rush, quickly comes there, gets into the vehicle and sees that the vehicle, in front of this vehicle, there's another car, which is very close. Now he or she is not going to see these two girls, right? And there is no vehicle there at the back. What is she going to do? What is the driver going to do? She's going to quickly reverse. She's in a rush. What's going to happen to these two girls? Never hide behind a vehicle. Never play on the road. road safety rules. I'll never play on the road. I will not hide behind the vehicle, and I will always obey traffic policemen. Helmet, day and night. Always wear a helmet, not just for the rider, but also a pillion rider. You tell me, you a lot of times you sit behind your father's riding a bike, your mother's riding a bike, and you sit behind. Your father wears a helmet, I hope. And why does he wear a helmet? Is it because there's a cop there on the road? Or it's because it saves his head. Helmet saves you from any head injury, correct? So when you sit behind, or your mom sits behind, you also have your head. Now who will protect that head? In fact, a pillion rider needs helmet much more than a rider. Why? Because a pillion is not aware of what's the situation on the road and how the rider is going to react. And you kids, my dear friends, you are small, you're lesser in weight. God forbid, if anything is to go wrong, you are thrown far away. So children need helmet always on the road. Another thing, helmet has to be brightly colored. Don't go for a black color helmet. If your dad has a black color helmet, ask him to buy a new red color helmet. It has to be, never buy a helmet on the road. The 200 rupees, 300 rupees helmet that's available on the road is of no use. You need to buy from a shop ISI marking ISI 44151, right? You see that mark there at the back of the helmet. It has to be full face, not that so-called ladies helmet, because this portion is then not protected. It should fit you properly, not too tight, your head will start aching, not too loose where it will move all over. You must always tighten the chin strap, because if you do not, you know, strap the helmet, it's going to give you a false sense of security. And God forbid, during a crash, your helmet will be at one place and your head will be another place. So it will work only when you strap it. And how do you strap it? Not too tight, not too loose. It should be just one finger gap between the strap and your chin. Use a visor of the helmet, the face shield that protects your face, also protects from the dust particles, wind, you know, the breeze on the road, some small mud particles may enter your eyes and you may lose balance, right? So use the face shield. A good idea, always have a retro reflector at the back. What is a retro reflector? Imagine there's a man who's traveling on the road. Bike lights are not on, or even if it's on, the truck comes from behind and he sees that rider much late. You know, it's quite late by the time the driver sees. But if there is a glow, you know, a sticker you've seen on the road, when you see actually on highways, those the back of the truck, those stickers are there and they're glowing like a light when the headlight falls on it, right? So that's a retro reflector. It reflects a light back. So have that, you know, a radium putty, or actually newer these days helmets come with a retro reflector. So that sticker needs to be there at the back, right, which glows in the dark. So a truck coming from behind and a light falls on the helmet, immediately the driver knows, oh, there's this fellow who's going on the bike. And that if you do not have your father's helmet, doesn't have that retro reflector, buy a radium sticker and put it there. That may save someone's life. So picture representation where this is wrong way. Do not, no buckling, sorry, no helmet is of no use. If you fasten it, but it's too loose, absolutely of no use. Look at this picture. Now imagine if this rider was, it's a full face helmet. But if this wasn't a full face, what would have happened to this portion, isn't it? What would have happened to the nose, eyes? It's very, very delicate portion of the body. So always stay protected with a helmet. Look at this. Wearing a motorcycle helmet correctly can result in 40% reduction of risk of death and 70% reduction to risk of severe injury. So have all those, you know, full face helmet, a comfort fit, the rigid outer shell, change the helmet after every 3 years. A bright color helmet, fasten it, not too tight, not too loose, just one finger gap. Let's watch this video. It's a live recording, okay? There is this fellow who's wearing a helmet, but let's see what happens. He'll come now. You see this where the red arrow is, that's where the helmet goes. So probably the strap was loose, or maybe he'd not even fastened the strap. So anytime you see your father going and he's not put the strap on, in fact, as soon as you complete watching this video, you must tell your father, you must tell your mother, you should always wear a helmet and buckle it, and how, not too tight, not too loose, just one finger. Otherwise, it is absolutely a false sense of security. Okay, it will not protect you. So, and why? Because bones heal. A lot of times you play on the road, you know, like you're playing on the ground, you fall, maybe sometimes you're badly injured, you have a, you know, a sling tied onto your hand, you're fractured, but after 10-15 days, maybe 1 month, you're back on the, you know, absolutely fit and fine. Head, it doesn't happen. Brains don't heal, and that's where you must stay protected every time you're on the bike, right? Always wear a helmet, buckle it properly. And the change starts with you. No point saying, oh, so many other children, nobody wears. But we're doing this session for your school. Why? Because we want you to be safe. And likewise, wherever you see these kids, try and tell them. Try and tell your, you know, discuss this with your friends and your society, that every child in your society should be wearing a helmet if he or she is a pillion rider. Let the change begin from each one of us. Seatbelt, the next point. The three-pointer seatbelt. What are the 3 points? See, there's a point here on the shoulder, you know, like it goes up. So that's 1 point, and 2 points down where you put the belt and you push it inside the buckle, right? You put it inside the buckle. So those are the 2 points here. So always you should have a three-pointer seat belt, and everyone, not just the driver, not just the co-passenger, but everyone. Let's watch this video. Always wear your seatbelt. Another video, let's watch it carefully.
Most crashes are head-on collisions. Let us see just what happens when one vehicle collides with another, or with a stationary object that's only 30 kilometers an hour. The result is the same as dropping your children headfirst from a third floor balcony. Now try to imagine a collision or rollover at 50, 80, 100, 120, 140 kilometers an hour. The human body is not designed to withstand such impact. In a split second, it is all over.
So, my dear friends, ensure that every person, every passenger inside the car is belted, right? And a three-pointer belt. A two-pointer belt actually poses a threat to your spinal cord. So a lot of times the center seat for at the back has two pointers. So ideally for long journeys and high speeds, you know, only four passengers if you have a center belt as a two-pointer is what is highly recommended. How do you wear a seatbelt? Now, there's a sash and there's a lap, right? So sash comes between the chest. There is no twist. There is no turn. It should fit you snugly, so not loose fit. And a lap should never be on your abdomen. That's the softest tissue in your body. God forbid, if something is to go wrong, the belt itself is going to cause grievous injuries, cut your stomach. So it has to be on the lap, okay? So below the belly, on the lap, pelvic bone is the strongest bone in the body and that takes the impact, right? So three-pointer belt, lap sash belt, no twist and turn, fits you snugly. Okay, this is what happens at the back if you're not wearing a seat belt. Anyone who's not wearing a seat belt is a threat, not just for himself or herself, but also others who are wearing belt. Because what happens is, like what will happen, you take a container, you know, you take a small bottle and put a small ball inside any object and shake it. What will happen to that object inside? It will go helter-skelter. Similarly, same thing happens to the life. That human body will be thrown onto the dashboard or up on the roof or the sides or to the other co-passengers. So please stay buckled up. When you buckle it, it should get engaged properly. When you remove the buckle, the retractors pull it behind, right? It just, you know, in a zip moment, it goes inside. Sometimes you see those old belts dangling there. They're not gone inside. Now that's probably the mechanism is faulty as the retractors are not pulling it back. Change it. Change the belt, get it. You know, get a new belt fitted. Let's move on. So the someone who's wearing a belt stays there. Somebody who's not belted at the back has moved ahead and he's not going to injure himself, but also going to injure the other passenger inside the car. So it's absolutely a must for all passengers. And we're not talking of high speeds. We're not talking of only highways and expressways, but as low as even 6 and 10 kilometer a speed. Trust me, you want to see it yourself. You want to convince someone else, you know, ask that person to sit behind. Now, as rear seat passengers, you're not constantly watching, you know, from which side the vehicle is coming and how the driver is going to react. So your dad is driving, sit behind, shut your eyes. Sit like this. If you have spectacles removed, you're going to request the dad to drive not beyond 10 kilometers an hour. And when he thinks it's right time, he's going to apply an emergency brake. Okay, you are seated like this at a speed of 10. The way you are thrown forward is enough for you to get convinced. No matter what speeds, no matter what roads, every occupant needs the belt, three-pointer, as soon as he or she gets into the car, right? Let's move ahead. Okay, kids. Now, if the three-pointer doesn't fit such a small baby, or even sometimes you kids, you know, sometimes you're really tiny, so the three-pointer doesn't fit you properly. It's hurting your neck, which means it's going to cut your neck, right? So we'll talk about for you kids how, what should be the situation. But for babies, you have all the possible, you know, in the car accessory shops, children accessory shops, you get these baby seats, you get these car seats, you know. So please ensure that in case if you have, you know, your siblings or anyone in the family with young babies, tell them you must buy child seats, but every occupant in the car needs to be belted. So there are rear-facing child seats, front-facing child seats. There are plenty of options available in the market. Now for kids like you and who are not tall enough where the seat belt doesn't fit you properly, like for example, this little boy in this bright yellow t-shirt without, you know, so how is the left picture shows it's hurting. Yeah, it's hurting him. So get a booster seat. What happens? You're at a height and that three-pointer seat fits you properly, right? Again, the change starts with you. Engine on, mobile off. Whether it's a bike or it's a car, if you're driving, and for the bike, as a rider or pillion, don't use your mobile when you're traveling. It's extremely dangerous, right? It's use of mobile phone while crossing the road or as pedestrians is equally dangerous. So please don't use it. Your eyes need to be on the task, which is as a pedestrian, you're walking, and your mind also needs to be on the task. So when you use those Bluetooth and purple tooth and pink tooth and hands-free, no. It's not about your hands being free, my dear friends. It's all about your mind being free. So in case if your dad is riding a bike with a Bluetooth, please tell him, Dad, don't do this. It's unsafe, right? Right? Eyes on the task, mind on the task.
Hello.
So increases the risk of a crash by 400%. Four times it increases your risk of a crash when you are talking on the phone, whether it's handheld or hands-free. Don't use it. A big no-no. Engine on, mobile off. Change starts with you, my dear friends. Why are we doing this program? Because I love my family, and I'm sure you too love your family. You want your dad every day back home safe. You want your mom every day back home safe. Similarly, your parents need you back home safe. Not all kids are going back home safe every day. What numbers are we talking about? Every day, more than 350 lose their lives on the road. This is not something, this is absolutely grievous. We have discussed this, right? So we're talking something very, very serious. And is road safety rocket science? You think I've told you something very, very complicated? No, it's out of common sense. In fact, it's far simpler than even brushing your teeth, right? How as a kid, mom has taught you how to brush your teeth. Today, nobody wants to remind you. What do? You get up. Before you come to school, the first thing that you do when you're off the bed is go to the washroom, wash your face, brush your teeth, then get fresh, then have your bath, then wear your clothes, and you come to school, right? If I tell you not to have a bath for one day or maybe 2 days and go to school, how dirty will you feel, right? But still, there is no threat to your life. But one day, which is not so fine, and you're not wearing a seatbelt, or you're not wearing a helmet, or you're using a phone, and something goes wrong, you may lose your life. So it's as simple as this. And you do these things, no matter what, you will be far safer. These wouldn't be the reasons for what you have, you know, injured yourself on the road, right? So you today probably unknowingly you were doing wrong. You know, you were not wearing a helmet because nobody wears a helmet as a pillion rider. No child wears a helmet on the road. But now you know, right? Like your dad wears a helmet because it protects his head. Now you also have a head. It needs to be protected. So maybe it's not just tomorrow that you will buy a helmet. So when tomorrow you are riding as a pillion rider, you are knowingly doing wrong things. You at least know this is wrong. This is unsafe for me, right? Now you have to move a step ahead. Do things knowingly right, which is buy a helmet. Start wearing it every time. Maybe one day you'll miss it, but then as soon as you sorry. So this is wrong. I need to go and get my helmet, right? So you'll need some reminders to a point. If you practice this daily, unknowingly, which means it'll be like, you know, you'll be part of your life. If I'm on the bike, I have to have a helmet. So if I'm in the car, I must be belted. That means unknowingly right things. Let's move ahead. So accidents may happen due to unforeseen reasons. No one knows that, you know, I'm going to get into a trouble. Use your head, use your heart, so know that I must do right things. Use your heart. My parents need me back home. Use your hands, which is pick up the helmet, put it, pick up the belt, wear it. Tell everyone around that these three things, helmet, seatbelt, and mobile phone, right? Because I also tell them this is very, very unsafe. So many people, you know, a hale and hearty person leaves the home. What numbers are we when we're talking of these 1,50,000? Majority of these crashes, these fatal crashes, happen to young drivers. They are in the age group of 15 to 35. So hale and hearty person leaves the house, doesn't even get a chance to come back home. Not because that's his choice, but because he or she is just no more. And a lot of times, you know, it's like I would say more than 95% this life is lost because of unsafe behavior. And it's no rocket science. Simple measures, safety measures will save life. And that's where we get closer to that achieving zero crashes, zero injuries, right? So now I have done my job of giving you this information. I want you all to be road safety champions. Will you help me to make yourself, you know, will you help me so that I can make you road safety champions? What kind of help I'm expecting from you guys? I want some assignment, you know. So what's the assignment? Not very complicated. It's going to be a project for you. It's a science project. What's going to be the type of activity? It's individual activity. Objective is importance of following road safety habits, right? Activity is write a short essay on road accidents in India. Especially share statistics and on what? Number of accidents. We rather call them crashes and collisions. So number of collisions in a year and compare it with the world. Major cause of road accident. What are the major reasons why road crashes happen? State and city with maximum accidents, and accidents in Thane city every year, right? So you have these points on which you have to write a short essay as an activity. It doesn't stop here. Also, make these bullet points, share an overview about three road safety rules: helmet, seatbelt, no mobile. And what are the points? Importance of following this rule. Share three points. Why should you wear a helmet? You know, go Google it, find information. Probably you'll find 10 different points. Take the three best you like. Similarly for seatbelt, similarly for mobile. Move on to the next. Things to keep in mind when wearing a helmet, or a seatbelt, what are the precautions? Like I told you, helmet has to be full face, it has to be buckled, bright color, retro reflector, your size, it should fit you, right? So find information and write 5 points. Similarly, seatbelt, buckle in properly, retractor should work, three-pointer seatbelt for every passenger, you know, not just driver and co-passenger, but every occupant. Likewise, mobile. Why do people not obey this rule? Give you reason. Why do you think that they don't use helmet, they don't use seatbelt, and they rampantly use mobile phones? Penalty for not obeying the rule in India. What's the penalty? Find it out yourself. Go search on the net. And your suggestions on how can we make people follow this rule? Share minimum 3 suggestions, right? That's going to help you. You know, that's going to make you a road safety champion. And I'm sure you want to, because we want you to be road safety champions. Instructions to students for doing this project. Project has to be executed on A4 size paper. So it looks synchronized. It looks everyone on the same, you know, like a A4 size paper. It should be handwritten. Don't exceed more than 2 pages. Project will be graded on the basis of quality of the content and overall presentation. It's encouraged to write as bullet points and not paragraphs. So information, we want statistics, information, your thoughts in bullet points. Once you complete the project, take a picture, a good clear picture, scan and send it to support@rnisargafoundation.com and put your class teacher's email address on CC. So teacher knows that you've done, you've completed your project. Make sure picture is visible and clear. Last day for submission is September 30th, 2020. Right? So a good road safety education lasts a lifetime. Road safety begins with each one of us. Thank you. Bye. Take care. All the best.